Listen to an assistant lecturer talking to a new student.
Excuse me, are you Mr. Fitch, Dr. Addlestone's assistant?
Hi, yes, can I help you?
Yes, please, if you have time. I'm Mary Jane Turner, and I'm signed up for Literature 220. I just wanted to get clear on the grading system. I'm still not sure how it works.
Hi, Mary Jane, sure. It's pretty straightforward, really. After each lecture, we prepare a short quiz in that material, and you take it at the beginning of the next lecture period. It only takes about 10 minutes, and it's pretty simple. If you've taken good notes and studied them a bit beforehand, that is. There are 15 lectures, so that's 15 quizzes.
And they're part of our final grade, right?
Right. 1% each, or 15% for all 15 of them.
Each one's only 1% of my grade? That doesn't seem like much. Missing one or two of them wouldn't make much difference, would it?
Not really, no. But the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. They're not worth much individually because they're very short and sweet. Just to check that you've been coming to class, really. But students who pass all 15 quizzes earn a 5% bonus for effort.
Don't our individual quiz scores count?
No, sorry. They're just pass-fail quizzes.
So pass them all and it's 20% of my final grade?
That's right.
That sounds good.
And 60% are your midterm and final exams.
Are they short and sweet too?
No, I'm afraid not. They're not like the quizzes. They're 90-minute tests and require a good bit of writing in addition to the objective questions. The midterm covers the first 8 lectures, the Founding Fathers to Mark Twain. The final mainly covers World War I to the present from Lecture 9 on.
So first half authors won't be on the final?
That's not what I said. I said it's mainly on the second half of the course. Professor Addlestone will be keeping you, honest with a few questions about American literature before the First World War II.
I see. And they're 30-30?
Yes. 30% for the midterm, 30% for the final, and up to 20% for the weekly quizzes. And then up to 10% each for your essays. You'll need at least a 90% for an A, 80% for a B, and 70% for a C.
Could you tell me something about what is expected with our essays? There are 2 of them, right?
Yes. You're required to write 2 short critical essays on American authors of your choice from anywhere in American literary history, and we'll be looking carefully at your writing style and ability as much as the content of your essays. The professor's a real stickler for overall literacy.
So I can choose any author in the syllabus?
Yes, but I can tell you that we often like it when a student picks an author out of the mainstream. Perhaps a lesser writer than we haven't been able to include in the lectures, or a contemporary author who hasn't found a place in literary history yet.
Someone really obscure?
Not a good idea. The author you choose should have some relevance to the course of American literature, and if you can demonstrate that relevance clearly in 4 to 5 typewritten pages, then you'll have a good essay.
For each essay? Ooh.
This is a university, Mary Jane, not a high school. Now you've got almost 4 months to write 8 to 10 pages. You should be able to manage that.
Yes, okay, you're right. When are they due?
Your first essay is due in late October. It must be handed in by Lecture 8, but we'd be happy to see it any time before that. And the second is due the last lecture in December. It must be turned in before the winter break.
Oh, should the first essay be about somebody in the first half's material then, and the same for the second?
No, not at all. Any author you like. It would be smart to choose ones that interest you, though. Perhaps that reflects some, enthusiasm always turn out better.
Oh, I've got that. I'm really looking forward to this course. I love reading.
That's good, because you'll be doing a lot of that.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Fitch. I really appreciate it.
And don't be shy if you have any more questions, Mary Jane. My door's always open. Goodbye. How'd you get so far?